This weekend I did a thing. I went to a wedding in Athens, Georgia. Five things I've learned from going to a country wedding. Five. Number one, do not let boots fool you. White country women twerk. DJ was playing some country songs, and y'all know I like country music, so I was vibing a little bit. I don't know if they waited till the old folks went to bed. I don't know what happened. But when Cash Money Records took over for the 99 in 2000, these white women created like a wall of China in the middle of the dance floor. And when I tell you I seen bridesmaids put their ears where their inner ankle is, I had never been. I wanted to shoot more than shots at everything out there. I mean, I'm from the hood. I'm from where they started twerking at. Twerking goes down at white weddings in the country in the woods with cowboy boots and cowboy hats. Do not be fooled. There's a party in the U.S. and not hell, nah. There's some twerking in the woods. I swear. Number two, the pastor can talk. Over the course of my life, I've been involved in many weddings, right? And usually the preacher gets up there and he introduces the couple, say a couple jokes to make the audience laugh, then they get on with it. Now, this pastor took us to church. He had his Bible open to the point where he almost asked the wedding party, okay, I would like everybody to turn to pastor. We ain't got our Bibles, pastor. We came to see these people touch and agree and become one, pastor. I understand that. But since y'all don't got y'all Bibles, I'm just going to read. If you haven't been to church in a while, go to a wedding in the South, mainly Georgia. That pastor stood up there and talked for about 4 days. I got there around 5 o'clock, around 2 a.m. He said, you may now kiss your wife. So we ain't going to even pass around the collection plates or nothing. Nobody ain't going to say nothing to Matlock. Matlock up there preaching for 65 years and nobody, okay. Number three, do not take a regular vehicle to a wedding in the country. My dog was getting married, so I wanted to show up and show out for my dog. So I went to Hertz, rented me a BMW, you know what I'm saying? I was feeling good, riding clean, flowing through the highway. Then all of a sudden, Siri told me, take a right at the cow in the stick in the road. I ain't never heard Siri sound like that. I took a right at the stick and the cow in the road. Then I end up in a place where I know the Blair Witch Project was filmed. If you are going to a wedding in the country, take you a truck, rent you a truck, get you an Uber that's a truck. Do not take no regular vehicle out there, because you're gonna go over terrains, you're gonna go over rocks, you're gonna run over dead people, you're gonna go through clouds, you might have some attacks, because see, people do that. They stop your car and ask you, can I attach my trailer to your truck? I know where you're going down the street. Me and him are buddies, and down the street ain't down the street because the neighbors live like 4 miles away. What happened when a storm go out and y'all ain't got no damn power? How you gonna go ask your neighbor for sugar in the country? Why do y'all live so far apart from each other? All this land ain't necessary. Listen, man, it's a lot of land out here. I can get 40 acres out here. Y'all ain't gotta give me 36 acres. Give me 21 acres in a dog. All right, 17 acres in a cat. Number four, white Southern people will mingle. Now, I don't know if it's what happened in the past in history, but black people, when we go to certain events, we real stand out because we stay in our lane. We stay on the wall. We don't really speak. White Southern folks, they will not let you go without speaking. It was a moment where I'm just chopping it up with my dog. We was over here in the corner. We just, you know what I'm saying, building, talking about some stuff. And the older white gentleman had to be in his early 60s. He was like, hell, what you boys doing? We're like, we just chopping it up. Okay. Smell like y'all doing more than chopping it up. Hell, I know what reefer smells like. Southern white folks have no problem walking up to the conversation, introducing themselves and putting themselves in the conversation because they are well-traveled. And by well-traveled, I mean they well-traveled their county, not even their state. But somehow, they know everything about the world. They know how to skin a cow. They know how to pick a cow. They know how to put a car together. They know how to take a car apart. They know how to shoot. They know how to take air, turn that into moisture in case we get thirsty. They know the different strands of weeds just by the smell and the way the cloud float up because my brother was burning, because I don't burn. I don't smoke no weed. It was my brother. It was all my brother. I didn't not get secondhand high and get hungry and stick my hand in that pot of food. That was not me. And number five, country weddings, everybody is so happy and act like they get married. It wasn't a dry eye in the building, except mine. I'm a strong man. When I see certain events, I get happy for people, but nothing makes me emotional. Until that first dance came and everybody around them started getting choked up and started leaning on their spouse, and I was just there by myself and I wasn't getting choked up, but then I seen Granny get choked up and then she got told she didn't know her husband, then the bridesmaids started getting choked up and they started crying, then the couple in the middle, they started crying, then the pastor, he was swinging back and forth with his 1918 Bible in his hands, and then the DJ got choked up and everybody was just so happy and I got emotional and I just asked the Lord, why? Why is so much emotion? Wow, so much emotion. And then Cash Money Records took over for the 99 and the 2000, and all that went away. And then the white women built that Great Wall of China and started twerking around each other. Nobody threw it on me, and I was jealous.